I'm with Michael Becker of the Becker Law Firm, and we're here in a gymnasium because, Michael, as you know, a gym, a cafeteria, places without quite as much structure seem to be places where bullying occurs. How do we tackle this problem?
It has to start by recognizing when bullying is occurring and then stop it in its tracks.
How do you do that?
You report it, or your friend reports it. Someone has to report it to somebody at the school, whether the teacher or principal.
I think you hit on something big there, because I wonder if kids think, well, I got to go to the police to do this. That's not necessarily the case, but you do have to get the information out.
No, kids have to understand that they have help right within the school by the laws of the state of Ohio.
How big of a challenge is that to get kids to take that step to at least get the information to somebody at the school?
Well, we know it's not easy for kids to speak up. It is a challenge, but they must speak up, or speak up for your friends.
This makes kids heroes when they take a step like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, they are heroes.
You know, this world of social media where things just take off instantaneously, spread throughout a school when it's captured on a cell phone, that's a big problem, cyberbullying.
Something like that can spread quickly within seconds throughout not only the school but the community. Tony, there's so many stories about bullying that one can find on the web. How do you guys choose what story to run with?
Make sure it falls under the category of bullying, and then make sure it's honest and it's accurate, and certainly that makes it worthy of a story. And again, it helps people to at the very least get the ball rolling and get the information out there. I really appreciate your passion on this. You're doing great work, Michael.
Thank you.
And remember, if you witness bullying, you can call 211. There are resources there 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.